I think it's time for another chick update. They're about 3 weeks old now. I'm pretty sure that's right. About 3.5, I guess. I've still only lost 3, so I should still have about 77, at least 80 in here. And they seem pretty happy, pretty healthy. I'm just giving them some water here. Just gave them fresh water and food for the day. Actually filling their feeder twice a day at this point. They went through their last bag of feed, 50 pounds of feed in 1 week. So I picked up 2 bags yesterday. I don't know if it'll last a whole week or not, but we'll see. I don't know if I can catch any. But this light colored one here, that's one of the Americanas, the Easter egg chickens that lay the colored eggs. Let's see. I'd say like this one right here that's black and brown. That is probably a speckled Sussex. And then the ones that are like these guys here, that there's the most of, those would be the dark Cornish. Still leaves me not sure about the one breed though, so I'm still trying to figure them out. They're putting on feathers, but they haven't really put on their full feathers yet. I just gave them some sour milk, some curds and whey too, so they're going after that there in that skillet. And I put some boards in here a while back, so they have something to start climbing around on or roosting on. They don't really roost at night yet, the way they will when they're older, but they do like to jump up on stuff and climb around a little. I've been gradually moving the lights up, so the heat's less intense. I still have them on about half the day, and they go off for a few hours during the day and a few hours at night to let them start to get used to the night cycle. Sleeping a little more, but they still seem to enjoy the warmth some, so I haven't turned them out completely yet. I figure they should be down here another week or two probably before I move them out to the barn, so I'll gradually be turning the lights off more and more to get them prepared for that. This is a lot of chickens for this space. It's big enough for them, but it's not going to last them that much longer. And I think I've added more bedding in here since the last time I took a video. More bedding, plus I brought down some grass clippings from when I mowed and let them stir through those. They're pretty active. They don't really have a whole lot to do. They'd like to be out pecking through the grass for bugs and things like that. So it'll be good when I can get them out there. They're getting a little less scared of me, but I don't spend a lot of time with them down here, so they don't exactly come right up to me or anything. Put some feed in this bowl because the feeder doesn't quite hold enough to go half a day. They seem to like to get in the bowl and scatter it all out first before they eat it, but they do eventually eat it, so that's all right. I guess that's just kind of their instinct to scratch through, like they're scratching the ground, looking for whatever they're going to pick up. They won't let me grab one, not very easily. So that's the update. They're getting bigger and putting on their feathers. I don't know how big they are now, but they've certainly grown a lot since I got them. They're going through about 4 times as much feed and water as they were. I brought the big waterer in here a while back. I don't know if that was before the last video or not, but I brought that in here because they're going through 4 or 5 gallons of water. They're going through better than a gallon a day at this point. Probably closer to 2 gallons, actually. Plus, they're getting some water out of the way there. So that's the update for this time, and I imagine I'll do at least one more of these while they're down here before I move them out to the basement, or excuse me, move them out to the barn, and I imagine I'll do another one then.